Hey guys, it's Paddy with another KineMaster tutorial.
Where have you been, Paddy?
I got delayed. We got delayed out at Sector 18, but it's okay. I found some footage on my phone that I want to edit in KineMaster and turn it into a video banner. This is for my page, I Love Port Macquarie Hastings.
This page looks pretty snazzy.
And you can find that on Facebook. In this tutorial, I'm going to cover everything from editing the footage to animating a logo, and we'll wrap things up by exporting the completed video and uploading it as my new Facebook banner. Ready to get inspired?
I'm ready, Paddy.
I meant them. Well, let's jump into KineMaster and import all the footage we need for this edit. I've actually made it all available to you, all my files, on my Google Drive.
I'm not giving you my email.
No email address required, so download them now if you like and follow along with me as we edit this footage. By the way, if you do edit the banner, upload it to your channel and drop a link below so we can check it out. I'm on my iPad in KineMaster. Let's select Media. Select the album I created with all the video clips I shot for this banner, and then let's tap on each of the individual clips to add them to the timeline. This last shot is a bit interesting because I hit record in portrait mode, then switched to landscape so the clip doesn't actually match our timeline, but that's not a problem at all. Select the clip, select Rotate Mirroring, and we can rotate the footage 90 degrees clockwise by clicking here. Let's pinch to zoom out on our timeline. By the way, did you know you can reorder your clips in your timeline?
I did not.
Simply select the clip, drag, and drop. Don't like the placement? Let's drag and drop again into a new position. I actually don't need this clip anymore, so let's select it and click the trash can to delete.
If you are so fly, why is your footage wobbling all over the place?
I never said I was perfect. I was out for a ride with no intention on filming anything, but it was just such a gorgeous day, and when we reached Town Beach, the surfers looked like they were having so much fun.
You jumped into the ocean to join them?
No, I decided I would grab my phone with the intention of just grabbing one shot.
You? One shot?
Yes, but...
impossible.
I thought maybe just one shot, and then... the next thing you know, I'm stopping at every landmark along the way.
You forgot to turn stabilization on, didn't you, Paddy?
Little did I realize I had turned stabilization off on my phone. Not ideal when you're filming in between heavy exercise, but the good news is it means we've got a nice editing challenge ahead to get all the best bits from each clip. Let's jump back in and edit and trim up this footage.
Oh, fun. Finally.
Let's select this first clip a couple of seconds in, click the scissors, then select trim to the right of the playhead to remove the unwanted portion. This is where I want to start the next clip. Select the clip, then scissors, and select trim to the left of the playhead. Click the play button to play back, and let's trim away the footage to the right of here. Apply this same strategy to each of your clips, but here's a cool shortcut when you're editing on an iPad. Select the clip, then click the Trim to Left of Playhead shortcut here. If you want to trim to the right of the playhead, click here. Let me fast forward to the interesting stuff. Now, even though there is no audio on a Facebook banner, there is still audio if somebody clicks on the banner to view it in a new window. So let's mute any clips with background noise by first selecting the clip, selecting the mixer icon, and then pressing mute. Another trick to tie two sequence shots together is to select our first shot and then extract audio. Now we can edit this audio independently and extend consistent sounding wave noises from my first shot across under our second clip or even multiple shots in our sequence. Just remember to mute the audio of any clips you want to underwrite with audio in this way. When the moon runs down the summer sky. I'm actually going to duplicate this track's audio and drop it under the rest of my clips. When the sea runs dry, we start to sing. Hand her from the sky. And now, it's time to animate our logo. The first thing is to get the logo into KineMaster with a clear background. I've prepped the file for you so it's ready to go and download, but for your interest, I'm using Photoshop to save my file in a PNG 24 format. I believe there are some good apps out there on the phone to help you do the same thing, and if you're watching this and you know one of these apps, by all means drop a comment below so we can check those out. I'm going to save the logo to a folder on my Google Drive, and then from my iPad, where I'm editing this project, I can browse to this folder, hit these little dots in the top right, and select Send a Copy, then Save to Device. Back in KineMaster, select Layer, then Browse Images, Recents, and this is our file here. Let's drag out the right handle to extend the logo to the full length of the video. Perfect. Now this I love, but as we switch to the next shot, I want to shrink down the logo so that we can see the surfers in the background. Select this key symbol here to bring up our keyframe tools. Click the plus symbol to add a keyframe, and then shuttle forward just a little bit and add one more. Now we can shrink and reposition the logo. That ought to do it. And then when we play back, boom! KineMaster keyframe animates both size and position. That looks awesome. Now, if the duration of that animation is a little slow for you, let's pinch in to zoom in on these little suckers, select keyframes again, and use this arrow here to navigate to our second keyframe. Now we can delete this, which also resets the logo to before we made our changes. And now, check this out, we move the playhead a bit closer to that first keyframe, then don't even click to add a keyframe, just go ahead and resize the logo and move it into position. The keyframe is added automatically at the playhead. Now let's play back and check out our timing. So the closer your keyframes are together, the quicker the animation takes place. For a slower animation, give more space between your keyframes. Now there is a gotcha here you need to be aware of. Provided we aren't going to add any other keyframes to our timeline, this logo will hold its size and position until the end of the clip. But I actually want it to pop back to full size over that last clip. So we add a keyframe and resize it, right?
Yes.
Well, you'd think so, but no.
What?
If we only add one keyframe, the logo's going to animate very slowly from our last keyframe to this new position and size. What we have to do is add two keyframes, one at the point where we want to hold over from our previous keyframe, and then a new one close by with the new position.
My brain hurts, Paddy. You handle the keyframes. I will stick to rocket science.
Now there is quite a bit you can do with keyframe animations, so let me know if you're interested
in
that.
Not interested.
And I can dive into it more in another tutorial.
No.
But for a quick win today, there are some super cool animations called clip graphics which are built right into KineMaster, and you can apply those in just a few seconds. Let me show you how. First, select a clip in your timeline, then select Clip Graphics. There are 17 free effects and dozens more for premium subscribers available from the KineMaster Assets store. And the one I'm using today is the social media clip graphic, which I think is awesome. There's actually a few different variations of this clip graphic, and you can try each one out and audition it until you find the one you really like. I think this one looks awesome. Okay, let's get this banner exported and uploaded to Facebook. Exporting is simple. Click the share icon and select your export format. Depending on your device and the resolution of your footage, you'll have different options here. Facebook recommends 820 by 312 pixels and between 20 and 90 second videos for their Facebook banners, but 1080p at either 30 frames or 25 frames per second has worked well for me. Once you've exported your file, it will appear in your camera roll. From your Facebook page, click here and browse to the new video. After the video has uploaded, reposition the video by clicking it and dragging it up and down. We covered quite a bit today, and I have some really amazing tutorials in the works, so hit subscribe to unlock new content from me, and if you're still here at the very end, drop a comment below so I can get to know my biggest fans whilst my channel is still small enough to be able to respond personally. Thanks for subscribing. That's it for now. I'll see you next time.
Oh dear, you did not make your bed. What will people think?